thank you for joining the CS board video about HyperDreamBooth, a new research paper from Google Research titled HyperDreamBooth, HyperNetworks for Fast Personalization of Text-to-Image Models. And as its title says, it lets you personalize text-to-image models. So with this method, we can take a pre-trained text-to-image model, like Stable Diffusion, and a reference image, such as this face image, and using HyperDreamBooth, create a personalized Stable Diffusion model within seconds. The personalized model can then, given prompts, create images that preserve the details of the reference image while enjoying the capabilities of Stable Diffusion. In this video, our goal, as usual, is to understand this paper by explaining how this method works. HyperDreamBooth is a follow-up work to DreamBooth, which was presented in a research paper from Google earlier this year, and it is one of the top methods to personalize Stable Diffusion already, together with other methods such as textual inversion. However, with DreamBooth, there is a need to fine-tune most of the entire Stable Diffusion model, which brings two noticeable shortcomings. One is that it is relatively slow to train, since there is a need to fine-tune the large Stable Diffusion model. And second is that the personalized models we get is of large size, which for Stable Diffusion it is approximately 1 GB. With HyperDreamBooth, the researchers address these shortcomings while keeping DreamBooth's capabilities. In the paper, they also present a user study where users chose which output they think is better between HyperDreamBooth, DreamBooth, and textual inversion, and we see HyperDreamBooth was preferred in most of the cases, even comparing to DreamBooth, which is very impressive. So let's start to understand how HyperDreamBooth works, starting with the high-level idea, so we'll know where we're going when we dive deeper into the details. So given a pre-trained Stable Diffusion model, we do not fine-tune the entire model, but rather use LoRA training for personalizing the model for reference images, meaning that small number of weights are added to the model layers, and only the added adapter weights are changing while all pre-trained weights kept frozen. This part is called Lightweight DreamBooth. This is just by itself is not a new method and was already tried, but here the researchers don't want to go through this process for each personalized model. So here comes step 2, where we also train a HyperNetwork model. A HyperNetwork model is a neural network that generates weights for another neural network, so in this case we train the HyperNetwork to predict the added weights instead of going through a LoRA training. In order for the HyperNetwork to be smaller, they actually use reduced weights for LoRA, as we will see soon. The third and last step is another fine-tuning after the weights prediction, which is fast since the predicted weights are already in the right direction. Since you don't need to go through step 1 in most cases, but only via steps 2 and 3, creating a new personalized model is super fast. Before moving on, if you like this content, then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. Let's now break down each of the three components in more detail, starting with Lightweight DreamBooth, or LiDB in short. As mentioned earlier, they use LoRA with reduced number of weights. So what does it mean? First, for each layer we have a matrix W, which are the pre-trained weights. With LoRA, we add weights such as the column and row here, which is smaller number of weights than the weights matrix W. But when we multiply the LoRA weights, we get a matrix of the same dimensions as W, usually noted as delta W, which represents the residuals added to the pre-trained W matrix. And the sum of W and delta W are the fine-tuned layer weights. To further reduce the added weights, they do a similar trick to LoRA and decompose LoRA weights further. So, for example, the column is decomposed to this 3x2 matrix multiplied by a 2x1 column, and the row is decomposed to a 2x1 row multiplied by a 2x4 matrix. But the cool thing here is that the left and right matrices are kept frozen. They are initialized with random orthogonal vectors and stay constant. So only the middle vectors are the added weights we train, and we see we train a smaller number of weights than LoRA. Using this method, the added weights to Stable Diffusion are only 120 kilobytes in size. Note that we've used rank 1 LoRA in this example, as they do in the paper. So this is why the LoRA weights are vectors and not matrices, but this can work for higher rank LoRA as well. The second component is HyperNetwork for first personalization of text-to-image models, where they train a HyperNetwork to predict all of the weights added in the Lightweight DreamBooth. The architecture is described with this peek from the paper, where we can see they use a visual transformer as an encoder to encode the reference image, and a transformer decoder to produce the predicted weights, where to produce the final predicted weights, they do an iterative process where the encoded of the reference image is computed only once, but the predicted weights are fed again, together with the image encoding, back to the transformer to improve them in each iteration. Finally, they use trainable linear layers to convert the decoder outputs to the layer weights. So this is the HyperNetwork architecture. But how is it trained? Here is another pic from the paper describing the training process. The training is done on a set of images, three in this pic for illustration. For each reference image, a ground truth weight matrix is calculated by training a lightweight DreamBooth. In the training process, they use a combined loss. They feed a reference image to the HyperNetwork, which yields the predicted weights. And from here, they take the first part of the combined loss, by comparing the predicted weights to the ground truth weights. The predicted weights are plugged into the text-to-image diffusion model, which is Stable Diffusion in the paper experiments. And Stable Diffusion is fed with the noise and the prompt. Notice the special word in the prompt, V in square brackets, which is a rare word which is trained to represent the reference face image. Stable Diffusion then removes the noise based on the prompts and using the plugged-in weights. And from here we get the second part of the loss, which is the reconstruction loss, where we expect to restore the reference image. The third component is ranked relaxed fast fine-tuning. By now, we have the Stable Diffusion model and the HyperNetwork model, which we feed with the reference image. The HyperNetwork then predicts the added weights to Stable Diffusion to make Stable Diffusion model personalized based on the reference image. But after the HyperNetwork prediction, the results are overall correct, but not of super high quality and lack details. So here they do another step of ranked relaxed LoRA fine-tuning on the reference image. They do that by introducing a new set of weights other than the predicted weights with higher rank. If you recall earlier, we used rank 1 LoRA and worked with one-dimensional vector. So here they add weight matrices, and this helps them to capture high frequency details, comparing to low rank weights. This was an intensive explanation, so please let me know in the comments below if you have questions about HyperDreamBooth, and I'll do my best to answer. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.